Now we have to draw this diagram in AutoCAD. So open AutoCAD window and just first of all select this isodraft option selected, and also select ortho option. So in selected mode, so this is a deselected mode and this is selected mode, and just take line command. And if you see, first of all dimension, so this is 110, height is 60, and this is 30, this is 40. Why? Because this is 20, 20, total 60. So remaining 20 means from here to here 40. So you can draw that one. So specify the first point. So in this direction, this is 110. So just type 110 and press enter. And I told height wise. So for that, select, change this isoplane by pressing F5. So by pressing F5, you can change this orientation of this isoplane. So keep it above and cursor, just type 60, because we have seen height 60. So type 60 and press enter, and in this direction we have seen it is 30. So 30 type and just press enter, and downwards we have to come 40. So please keep this cursor downwards and type 40 and just press enter, and in this direction, so total is 110, this is 30 means, so anyway this will be 80. So 80, enter, and just keep your cursor here. So it's matching here, so small green box, so click there and press enter to come out from the command. And in this direction we have to draw. So once again, just take this line command and so change this isoplane. So press F5. So now it is changed. So select the first point, and here the length will be 90. We have seen, if you see this, so this is 90 means, so this is also 90. So to give that, to draw that, so type 90 and press enter. And height we have seen 60. So keep cursor above and type 60 and press enter. And in this direction, we have seen 90. So type 90 and press enter. And so this is 60 anyway, 60 height, enter. See here, this is 30, 20. So because total 90, 30, 30 given, remaining also 30. So you have to come like 30, 20, 30, 20, 30, 20, like that. So keep towards front side the cursor and type 30, enter, and put downwards, type 20, enter, and once again put front 30, enter, and keep down 20, enter. And here you can keep like this and type 30, and or also directly you can join with this point. So join with that point and just click and just come out from that, press enter. And once again you have to draw the above, suppose. So change the isoplane orientation by pressing F5 and take line and select the first point. This we have seen 110, so type 110 and press enter. And in this direction it is 90 we have seen, or you can directly select this point and just press enter. And once again from this side you have to come, so take line command and click here. So this is total is 110, so this 30 we have seen, so this will be 80. So type 80, enter, and directly you can join here, or you can type 30 plus 30, 60 also, and directly joining. So keep here the cursor, so it is highlighting green small box, so click here and just come out, enter, and change this isoplane orientation F5, and take once again the line command, and so select the first point, and this will be, we have seen it is 80, enter, and you can change the isoplane orientation F5. So this direction is 30, so 30, enter, and downwards 20, type 20, enter, and directly you can select this point and just press enter. And we have to join these lines, so take line command and change the isoplane orientation, and select the first point here and here, and once again select the line command and select first point, second point, and just press escape. So we have drawn the diagram, and but we have to indicate the dimensions here. You see, we have to indicate the dimensions. So dimensions will be 110 here, and this is 60, 20, 20, 90, 30 here, 30, 30 here. So to give dimensions, so select here, beside to the dimension, select this drop down arrow, so go for aligned, and so select this first point, second point, and keep some distance, and just click here. And also next, this dimension we have to give. So press enter to continue. Dimensioning, first point, select point, keep some distance, press enter. And next, to give this also, press enter to continue dimensioning. Select this first point, second point, and keep some distance, and press enter. Next, we have to give this dimension also. Press enter to continue. Select the first point, second point, and keep some distance, and click here. And we have to give this also dimensions. So to continue, press enter, and select first point, second point, keep some distance, appropriate distance, just click, and press enter to continue. And we have to give here also, so first point, second point, and keep some distance, and just click, left click that, and also just enter to continue. Here also we have to give here and here, and select the first point and the second point, keep appropriate distance here, so click, and just press enter to continue. And here, first point, second point, put appropriate distance and press enter. And here, so we have given dimensions, so just press escape to come out from the command. And but these are not parallel with this isometric lines of the diagram. So to make it parallel, just type the command dim edit, so dim edit. So we have got here, so dim edit, this is a command, so we got here anyway. So select that and go for oblique, and select the dimension which you have to make parallel, click and press enter. And you have to keep this dimension parallel to this line, means this extension lines should be parallel to this line. So select the first point here and the next point here, so it is parallel. So to continue that, press enter and go for oblique. So here also click and press enter, and select the first point here and second point. So next, to continue, press enter, choose oblique, and select the dimension, press enter, and to make it parallel to this line, click here and here. So next, 60 also, to continue that, press enter, go for oblique, select this dimension, enter, and to make it parallel with this line, so select first point here, second point here. And next, to continue, press enter, go for oblique, and select this one, press enter, and to make it parallel with this line, select first point here, second point here. Next, to continue, press enter, go for oblique here, and here also anyway you can select here also, select the dimension, and press enter, select the first point. So we are making this extension lines of dimension parallel with this line, so such that we are selecting first point here, second point here, and we have this 30, 30 also. So press enter to continue, choose oblique, select this dimension, press enter. So we are making this line, extension lines, parallel to this line. So select the first point here, second point here, and to continue, press enter, oblique, select the dimension, press enter, select the first point here, here. So so we got all dimensions, and we make them parallel to this diagram also, all dimension lines. So if you want to change the size of this dimension value. So the anyway here it is appropriate value size is there, but if you want to change, first of all type the command here dim style. So dim style, so dim style is the command. So dim style here you can find here, select that and press modify and go for text lines symbols are there. So go for text out, select text, and here text height. So 5 is the appropriate size we have selected previously, so it is appropriate size. Suppose if you select 4, that will be become something small. So suppose 4 if you select, and if you select okay, and just observe this dimension size, that will be make some will modify to some small size. So just close. So these are modified to some small size. So any size 4 or 5 appropriate size you can select based upon the diagram size. So this is the way to draw the isometric view of any diagram in AutoCAD. So for more videos, please subscribe and activate bell symbol, and also please share my videos with your friends. Thanks for watching.